Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. Find the limit of sine squared of pi times square root of n squared plus n as n goes to positive infinity. How to derive the limit? We are going to apply the following simple and important identity. Sine of x minus n times pi equals positive or negative sine of x. We can easily to prove this identity using the difference formula for sine. Taking squares on both sides of this identity, then we have sine squared of x minus n times pi equals sine square of x. How to use this result to our question? We can consider this part is x. That means x equals pi times square root of n squared plus n. Sine squared of x equals sine squared of pi times square root of n squared plus n equals sine squared of x minus n times pi, which is sine squared of pi times square root of n squared plus n minus n pi. We can factor pi out, which is pi times square root of n squared plus n minus n. Both numerator and denominator times the conjugate of square root of n squared plus n minus n, which is square root of n squared plus n plus n. Continue to simplify the numerators. We have square root of n squared plus n squared minus n squared, which is n, then times pi for the numerator. This is our question. We want to find the limit. This means we want to find the limit of the inside part. Limit of pi times n divided by square root of n squared plus n, then plus n, as n goes to positive infinity. Both numerator and the denominator divided by n. The numerator is pi. The denominator divided by n, we can move n into the inside part of the square root, which is n squared. N squared divided by n squared equals 1. N divided by n squared equals 1 over n. The outside, n divided by n is 1. As n goes to infinity, we can see this. 1 over n goes to 0. Therefore, the denominator goes to 1 plus 1, which is 2. Therefore, the limit is pi over 2. The inside part is pi over 2. Therefore, we can move the limit to the inside part. This limit equals half pi. Sine half pi equals 1. 1 squared equals 1. Therefore, this limit equals 1. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.